guys, welcome to another video. So, in this video I will teach you how you can mod Echidna Wars dishes. Firstly, I need to say that I am not American. My English is not so good, so forgive me if you cannot understand me very well, okay? But any question, please type in the comments, right? So, firstly, you need to download Echidna Wars Everdriven from the Patreon of tridelta. This link is below under the description. So you will need to this little program ASP. The number maybe can change because you have any updates sometimes. But the version that I tried is this version. So I will share with you in description. But this Echidna Wars Everdriven I can't share with you. So the only way I have to take this is getting on the Patreon of the tridelta. But I will put the link for the Patreon on the description, right? So when you have these two things, you will instruct here, okay? Oh, where you want to keep the game, okay? So I will extract here with this paste, this folder, right? Is this folder that I have extracted from the just archive, right? So here I have all the archives from this mod. In true, you do not need the original game, okay? But with this mod, you cannot play. In this mod, you don't have an executable, so you don't have any way to play the game, okay? You will need instruct the ASP. So, I will put this archive here inside the folder, right? Archive here, and extract here to the same folder. So now we have these two folders, alright? Here we have the mod, and here we have this program. Let me organize this. So in this way we have only one folder inside, okay? And here we have the three folders, but here we have some skins that are inside the archive, some notes, and here the mod is the game. But how I said before, you cannot play with these archives. You will need this archive, alright? We need to put this archive start.hesp inside this program. Let me see. Here is this. Let me see how you can do this. I will open another window. Is this one way, alright? It's not so easy. So, let me see. Here we have the program ASP, and here we have the mode. We need to take this archive start.esp, and we need to clock and put inside over the archive. This archive. This window will open. When this open, you press 5. So the game open. It's not so easy, but it's not so easy, but you have other way that is creating a batch archive. So how is I do with my version? Let me open. I create this archive with a batch. So inside this we have all commands to start the game. Alright, so if you put this on the same folder here, let me show. We command in this batch to start the ESP and start the game. So now we have the three archives. I will put the command in the description, and so you need to only copy and create another batch archive. The way to create a batch archive, I think that you know, but you need to create a test archive. So you put the command here. Let me see, I will copy this and you open you note and paste, but you save. All right, you will rename txt to bat. So now we have the archive bat. This is a archive that it run in commands, any program or way commands that you want. So to make this way this thing more easy, I will get the ESP and put here inside, and take the same batch and put inside. So now we have the three things inside and run the game from the batch. Now only press F5. So it's not so easy, but I hope that you understand. How I said before, you put all the things inside the Echidna Wars Everdriven mode. So the only way you have to play the game is with ESP and the mod. To make more easy, I created this archive bats. So click 2 times and the game will open. But you need to, of course, if press F5. Alright, so I hope you have understand. Again, I say forgive me for because my English is not so good, but I hope you have understand. Any questions, please put in the comments. All right, so thanks for watching, see you next video, bye bye.